वेलकम टू द ईपीजी पाठशाला द मायसेल्फ सुप्रियो चंदा हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ म्यूजियोलॉजी यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कलकत्ता द मॉड्यूल इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ म्यूजियोलॉजी अ हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव एंड द कोर्स इज इंडियन कल्चर and the paper is museology. The learning objectives or whatever we may learn today is on the history and growth of museology in the world, history and growth of museology in India, factors that determine the growth of museology, the relationship between museums and the museology, and the current situation in India and so on. The word museology was initially used to denote the study of the theory of museum operation, while the techniques and practice of museum activities were referred to as museography. Though nowadays this term museography has become a redundant and substituted by the word scenography. And a lot of other terms were used like museology, museum studies, museography, museum science, museum technology, museum techniques, museum practice, eco-museology, new museology, integrated museology, total museology, critical museology, etc. But all the same, they were all included in the term museology. And the basic questions comes, what is museology after all? Is a science or just practicing work? Do museology can be equated with grandmotherology, as some of the scholars referred to? Does it mean that anyone working in the museum would automatically be qualified as to be called as the museologist? A very vocal refrain is there that museum theory is nonsense and irrelevant, and the practice is the answer. Another common refrain is there that there is no museum profession at all. So naturally, no such necessity for having a specialized museology courses and training. And the emergence of museology as an independent discipline had really a lot of historical perspectives. It cannot be said to the about the subject itself. It has got its theory, but the subject doesn't have that much of theoretical background behind it. The scientific basis of the museum work appeared to be a shaky foundation. The need to lay the theoretical framework on which the museum movement as a whole can develop was urgently felt. Jiri Neuspinney defined museology as the theoretical aspects of museum work consisting of scientific research and collecting, educational activities, conservation, exhibition, theory and technique. Neuspinney, who conceptualized special museology consisting of application of subject discipline to museum work as an applied science serving museum fields. I may add here also, the museology departments in India grossly follow Neuspinney's concepts. And in the world level, the UNESCO Regional Conference at Rio de Janeiro defined museology as a branch of knowledge concerned with the study of the purposes and organization of museums. 1963 ICOM General Conference resolved that a curator should be trained in museology. In 1959, George Henry Riviera, a French museologist, stressed research on museology as a discipline. The professional training of museum personnel in the world, actual state of the problem in 1972, states that museology is museum science. With the study of history and background of museum, role in society, research, conservation, education, organization, relationship with the physical environment, and with the classification of different kind of museums. And Singleton's emphasized that a curator needs to be trained partly as an historian, partly as a scientist, a philosopher, an educationist, partly as showman, and partly as administrator and manager. Jed Stransky, who demised just last year, added the core of museology as the human society of conserving against natural decay, certain objects, and creating which represent the man, certain values closely linked with humanization. Mostly the Indian museologists follow the Stransky's philosophy. To other terms of museology, the critical museology and new museology, and the critical museology emphasizes museum as a profession, while the new museology deals with the museum like activities in the society, like the eco-museums and the integrated museums, all comes under the purview of the new museology. And the recent developments in the field of museology has resulted due to the globalization, and it changed the socio-economic, political and cultural milieu. There is felt a need to develop new museum audiences in order to cope up with a paradigm shift that necessitated to redefine museum as contact zones. This has had a catalytic effect on heritage institutions, and particularly to the museums, in search of new identity that recognizes the cultural diversity is a historical and social reality at the local, regional, national and global levels. There has been another parallel paradigm shift is thinking of the primary commodity of the museum as information rather than artifacts. It stressed much on the information related with the artifacts, putting the artifacts at the background. The report on the cross-cultural issues of the ICOM in 1997 called for development of inclusive museology, that is to include all intercultural and cross-cultural issues, especially the countries which are pluralistic countries like India. We have to adopt this kind of museology to include all the regional and sub-regional ethos. Another interesting development was the total museology that aimed to invent a new museography with three components at a time in different interactive ways. They are able to express themselves in hands-on mode, on mind-on, that is the interpretative things, and the heart-on, that is that emotion. That means the activity, the emotion and the intellect combines to form a museology that is called total museology. They are objects that tell stories, that talk to each other and to the visitor, a constant dialogic process between the exhibits, between the exhibits and the visitor, between the visitor and the curator, and the exhibits and the curator. That completes a total cycle, that's why it's called total museology. No doubt, after all these things, there is a subject of study based on museums and its purposes, that is called museology. Now the question comes, whether museology a professional discipline? It surely is an academic discipline and a practicing profession aiming at a further development and improvement of activities of museums and heritage institutions on the basis of a strong and very, very solid theoretical background. The theory and the methodology are the foundation of all aspects of museology and its functions. Museology must also put more emphasis on the intangible components to supplement the gaps in the storyline. That is the major drawback in our museum, especially in the Indian museums, where the tangible components of the heritage, that is the artifacts, don't tell the stories behind it. The intangible components must be documented, must be complemented to complete the whole story. So we can define, rather redefine, the museology as the philosophy of visual interpretation of heritage, maybe cultural, maybe natural, or maybe scientific. And now I come to the points on the developments of museology in India. Actually, the necessity felt long back, even in the 1907. And government of India stressed on the need for advanced museum training in 1912. In fact, the then government of India started or planned to start museology courses, but due to the successive world wars, First and Second World War, the scheme of things changed. Though in between, the government appointed Markham Hargreaves to visit the museums and to come up with a status report, which they did in 1936, and they highlighted the requirement of a professional training on the museums. Even in 1937, the All India Museums Conference also elaborated such training modalities, and it dealt in details and came up with a report. Sir Leonardo Uli also emphasized on staff training in 1939. This was obvious, otherwise by then many new museums came up and they were striving to have trained staff, trained manpower to run. All culminated in starting museology courses in the university level, first in the Maharaj Sayajirao University in Baroda, and then that was in 1952, and after 7 years in 1959 at the University of Calcutta. In another interesting development, the UNESCO deputed Professor Philip Rawson to study the museology courses in India, because by then India was the only nation who was having a separate museology departments in the Indian universities. And he came up the report is a very famous report. It was named the Rawson Report, Philip Rawson Report, 1965. It says that India is leading the world in the university training museology students. The postgraduate university course, first in Baroda and then at Calcutta, has set a notable precedence among a lot of other things. Presently, the major university museology departments in India are in the Maharashtra Sayajirao University, Baroda, in Gujarat, University of Calcutta in West Bengal, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh, and the National Museum Institute for History of Art, Conservation and Museology, New Delhi, and recently the Rabindra Bharati University in Kolkata, again in Kolkata. The following the success of the museology courses, mainly of the Baroda and the Calcutta, the renowned institution which trains science and technology at Pilani, the BITS, the Birla Institute of Technology and Science, it started an MSc Tech course in museum studies to cater to the needs of the growing sector of science and technology museums and science centers. Unfortunately, the courses discontinued after a few years. In recent years, some other centers have come up for training museologists at different levels, at Gwalior, at Delhi, and Bhopal, Hyderabad, Tirupati, Kerala, in many places where the museology is also taught along with the other subjects. And now we may come to the relationship between the museums and museology. It is true that museology originated within the periphery of a museum, but it has long surpassed its creator. Museology has definitely emerged as an independent discipline, resting on firm foundation of distinct philosophy and application. In fact, museology is a very potent tool to run the museums. Museums are its laboratories. Its horizon is very wide. Museology deals with many topics. To become a proper museologist, you need to deal in many disciplines so that you can grasp a lot of things. Museology has as much relationship with the museums as, jokingly you may say, zoology has got that with the zoos. Not more than that. Museum do need museologists for desired functioning. Unfortunately, what is not happening in most of our museum in present day, because museology demands multidisciplinary aptitudes and highly demanding and develop multitasking skills. A properly trained museologist, among many other things, could be an efficient curator, an expert exhibitor, a competent organizer, a great communicator and interpreter, an able visualizer, an educator, a copywriter, a preventive conservator, and a very good manager to deal with managing cultural objects. Unfortunately, the relevance of the subject and its potentiality are yet to be properly utilized and explored by the concerned authorities. Now we may come to the comparative study on the major museology courses in India. Naturally, we may start with the first course that was started in the Sayajirao University, at Baroda, commonly known as MS University. We may say here that the museology courses in Indian universities, all of them put equal emphasis on the theory as well as practice of core museological principle with a blending on the basic academic disciplines. The MS University, who started a one-year PG diploma course in 1952, it changed into a two-year PG diploma and finally MA fine degree from 1978. The course contents stress mainly upon museum training. The Department of Museology, University of Calcutta, it was set up in 1959, started directly with a two-year PG diploma course and upgraded to the MA and MSc degrees from 1970-1972. The department presently offers a two-year, four-semester, both MA and MSc degree courses in museology, as well as has higher degrees in PhD, both in the Faculty of Arts and in Faculty of Sciences. The thrust areas of this department and the strong points have been on the equal emphasis on the application as well as on the theoretical foundation. That the it trains the students to have multidisciplinary approach and acquire multitasking ability to cope up with the challenging global situation. The University of Calcutta course does not put much emphasis on the museum training only. It also stresses the basic disciplines, because after all, the museologist has to deal with the collection, and the museologist must know the basic, the background of the subject they are dealing with. The next university, the Banaras Hindu University, BHU Banaras, it started the offering MA course in museology under the aegis of Bharat Kala Bhavan, though now the department and the museum has been separated. This course also, as usual, stresses on museum training, specifically for the art and archaeology museums. Next comes the Aligarh Muslim University. It started offering PG diploma and post MSc diploma and continued for quite a long time. Since 2004, it started offering MSc in museology under the Faculty of Life Sciences. This is the only museology department in India which is housed under the Faculty of Life Sciences, and the course stresses, naturally the course stresses on the museum training, mainly for the natural history museums. And the National Museum Institute, commonly known as NMI, it was set up as a deemed to be university in 1989, started offering MA degree in History of Art, Conservation and Museology. The MA course is a quite flexible one. It's a four semester course, but the students can complete it from between 2 to 5 years. And being situated with the National Museum, naturally the much stress is given on the museum training only. And the new one has been the Rabindra Bharati University at Kolkata Jorasanko. It is situated within the very renowned heritage building of Calcutta, the dwelling of Tagore's, where the Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore he was born there, and incidentally, unfortunately, he died there also. The department is situated in that same building. The course stresses on core museology subjects, and relevant academic subjects as specialization. Museology courses, though, are very high standards in India and are of different varieties. The major Indian museology departments have collaborations and training programs with museums and universities in India as well as abroad. In fact, the Department of Museology of the Calcutta University has a memorandum of understanding with the University of Glasgow. The National Museum Institute is having a collaborative program with the Leicester University in the UK, and almost all the museology departments are having collaborative projects. Most of the curricula involves internship and projects in the museum and heritage institutions. Teachers, research fellows, students, all are involved and very actively in the professional development, professional organizations like the Museum Association of India, which is a predecessor to the International Council of Museums, and also all are very much involved with the International Council of Museums, that is an autonomous body under the umbrella of UNESCO situated at Paris. And Indian museology departments regularly upgrade their courses and the faculty improvements to cater to the needs of the growing changes of the museums in the country and to increase employability of their students in the museums. While emphasizing on the requirement of development of trained manpower for the museums, the former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, in his speech on the occasion of bicentenary celebration of the Indian Museum on 2nd February 2014, pointed out that, quote unquote, unfortunately, museology is a woefully neglected field in the country. And now we can summarize what we have discussed in the so far. We can safely say that, and it has become apparent that museology is an independent academic discipline by its own merit. It must not piggyride other subjects, and it cannot be aligned with or supplemented or as an adjunct to other departments like the ancient history or archaeology or maybe anthropology. But museology is, by its own merit, principally deals with quote unquote how, because the museologists know how to show, how to display, how to exhibit an object, and we emphasize rather than the what, when or where, because for these questions we may have answers from the expert academics from all over the disciplines. Majority of the persons running the Indian museums presently belong to the specializations other than museology. That is a point to be underlined, and there must be a clear-cut policy on museums and museology in the highest policy making levels in the India government. So far we discussed about the genesis of museology, definitions, changing definitions over the period, on the history of the development of museology in India and abroad. We discussed about the different museology courses and its salient features. We discussed about the current situation. We discussed about the pathetic situation of the museology students in India. We also gave some ways to solve the problem. If you have some other questions, you may also go through the e-text, which may complement your queries. There are other two components too, and there are other modules which can give you the clear idea about the museology, what it is, and hope to have had a clear idea about the topic. For more information, you may also log in to the epg.infibnet.ac.in. Thank you.